Ay, no se pueden imaginar quién está en Fernanda Talks Home. ¿Han oído hablar del doctor Joe Dispenza? Él, escúchalo por favor. No, es un agasajo. Dr. Joe, hi, how are you? It's a pleasure meeting you. Thank you for being here at Fernanda Talks Home. You're at home, I can see that.
And so are you. Yes, I'm happy to be with you.
Thank you. How are you living these times?
Well, I think this is a really important time for many people to decide on a new set of values. For me personally, I'm traveling a lot less. I'm seeing it as an opportunity to get more balanced physically, emotionally, chemically. I think it's a great time for us to pause and decide who we want to be when this pandemic passes, and apply some of the principles of deciding what we can change into and transform ourselves and step back into the world different people. And what a privilege to work from home every single day. And I think the world as we know it is going to change a lot. And I do think that this is about understanding a better relationship with your body and the truth about what your body's capable of doing.
Because this is not home office. This is home life.
Yes. And a lot of people are seeing it as in a state of fear or a state of hopelessness or a state of anger and frustration. And I want people to know it's those very emotions that literally weaken our immune systems, and we become more susceptible to bacteria and viruses because our emotional reaction, our response, is actually weakening the living organism.
200 years ago, we were dead because of viruses, bacteria, fungus. Now we're dying because what we eat and what we listen and what we feel in that way. I mean, that this virus goes into you if you have a diabetes or you have a certain weight. And that is something, no? I mean, we have to learn a lot about what is happening now.
Well, first of all, the truth be told is that your body right now is fighting viruses and bacteria. You have an immune system that is your internal protection system, and it's busy making sure that your body stays in balance. And so 200 years ago, we were exposed to many different viruses, and 500 and 1,000 years ago, we were exposed to many different types of bacteria. And it's true that this particular virus, if you have a pre-existing health condition that causes your body to be chemically out of balance, to be physically out of balance, to be emotionally out of balance, you are more prone to the effects of the virus. But by the same means, our research shows that if you could take a moment and open your heart and feel an elevated emotion like gratitude or thankfulness or appreciation or inspiration or love, and you understood how to self-regulate for 10 minutes a day, feeling that emotion for no reason at all except you decided to feel that way. If you did that for 4 days, you would strengthen your immune system by 50%. 50%, our research shows. So now that internal protection system that's busy memorizing bacteria and viruses, that army is more prepared for viruses and bacteria because you're signaling gene responses that actually strengthen your immune system. Fear, anxiety, worry, panic, frustration, aggression, no, anger weakens your immune system. So the relationship people have in understanding that their body is capable of doing amazing things, that yes, we should follow all the protocols that are in place, but what we fear has power over us. And people have to understand that their immune system is already very strong. And certain people that have pre-existing health conditions that are on certain medications, those medications actually upregulate genes in their lungs for inflammation. So some of the medications people are taking cause them also to become more susceptible to foreign agents.
Dr. Joe, what learning is leaving you, what is happening in the world these days? Because sometimes I work in the media, and Dr. Joe, I see news, and sometimes it's, you feel so vulnerable, so alone, so this is like apocalypse, no? Sometimes it is horrible to see what is happening around. What are you learning from this?
Well, I mean, look, if you study principles around order and disorder, information, the technology, in order for something new to be created, systems have to go into disorder before something new is created. And so chaos or disorder is a stage in which order comes out of. In fact, if you study chaos, it'll say chaos is just unpredictable order. It's novelty of information. So politically, economically, medically, education, journalism, the environment, religion, health is all breaking down. Now, that means then something better has to come out of this. Even though it looks like apocalypse or tragedy, it's the breaking down of old paradigms, Fernanda, that no longer can sustain themselves in this current age. And so you'll realize then that because of technology, people don't need a doctor to gain information about their health. They don't need a teacher to gain information or knowledge about anything. They don't need a priest or a rabbi to gain information because they have access to technology. And so the idea of using an authority to gain information as an old model is changing, and people are becoming empowered. Now, the next question is, what information is the truth and what information is just more ignorance? And so this idea of discerning and learning what is true is really kind of a new level of human consciousness. So I'm very optimistic that as all this begins to fall apart, that something better will emerge. And it has to take a collective group of people that are beyond self-interests. In other words, beyond self-serving motives, to really begin to think about how they're going to make a difference to the entire world. And we're more awake, more alive, more connected than we've ever been because of this particular situation.
But Dr. Joe, then talk us about the importance of what we see and what we hear as food for the soul.
That's
the question.
No, of course. When people reach the end of their beliefs, I mean, some people believe, not consciously, but subconsciously, that they're limited, that we have been programmed, Fernanda, into believing that we need something outside of us to change how we feel inside of us. Consume a product, take a pill, do something that is going to make you feel better, but you have to rely on your outer environment to do it. Well, that's okay because certain people need that kind of help. But the new model really is about learning information about you. And science is that language to demystify the mystical. The more you understand the truth about your biology, the truth about our history as a species, the truth about what's possible as human beings, and they learn that information. That information is knowledge, and knowledge and information, when you learn something new, changes the way your brain works. It actually changes connections in your brain. So learning is making those connections. And so as we learn information, we begin to install hardware in our brain. But the next question is, What are you going to do with that information? Are you going to use it? Are you going to apply it? Are you going to personalize it? Can you demonstrate it? And if you can get your behaviors to match your intentions, you should have an experience. The experience then of that knowledge produces an emotion. And the moment you feel the emotion, now you're teaching your body chemically to understand what your mind is intellectually understood. You begin to embody the truth of that knowledge, and now you begin to wear it.
So ego can destroy the connection in your brain?
Well, no, listen, when we stop learning information and we listen to media or news that has a strong sensationalistic component to it that creates strong emotions, well, people only accept, believe, and surrender to information that's equal to their emotional state. So if you're feeling fear, you're feeling fear, I want you to know that you are the information that you hear, if you're in fear, is actually going to program your autonomic nervous system to ultimately begin to behave in certain ways. So then if you change your emotional state and you overcome fear or you overcome aggression or anger, then you will not be suggestible to that information any longer. And this is how people evolve out of limited understandings.
So it's everything is how do you think about things or emotions or the senses? Everything has to be in your mind.
Well, let's explain it this way. Most people reach a certain point in their life, usually around 35 years old, maybe a little bit older, but they're thinking the same thoughts, they're making the same choices, they're doing the exact same things, they're creating the same experiences that they can predict.
The same decisions.
Yeah. Making the same decisions, feeling the same emotions every single day, and their biology, their neurocircuitry, their neurochemistry, their hormones, their gene expression stays the same because they're the same. So then information may not be fully comprehended and learned. And what takes people to this edge is crisis, trauma, disease, diagnosis, loss.
Chaos.
When they reach a point in their life where they're no longer interested in the same routines, this is the moment they begin to wake up. And my message is, why would you want to wait for that? You know, why would you want to wait to that point where you feel so bad that you finally have to make up your mind to change? So what an amazing time in history, because this is a time in history where information is so available, it's not enough to know. It's a time in history to know how to apply that information. And common people around the world that embody this information are healing themselves from cancer, from diabetes, from rheumatoid arthritis, from MS, from genetic disorders, from Parkinson's disease, to all kinds of different blindness, deafness, because they're not relying on someone or something to take care of them. They're learning the science about how to take care of themselves, and through that process, applying every principle so that they can express a greater level of themselves to the world. And that's a cool thing to see. So what an amazing time to be alive.
That's consciousness, right?
That's absolutely conscious. Consciousness is awareness. And that 95%, by the time we're 35 years old, becomes a set of unconscious thoughts, behaviors, and emotions. So the first step to change is to become conscious of your unconscious thoughts, to become aware of how you speak and how you act, to notice how you're feeling. And most people don't think they have the power to change that. But absolutely, wow. Our research says you absolutely do.
Dr. Joe, in a couple of minutes in this Fernanda Talks Home, where does your strength lie? I see you. I can feel you in this moment. So strength, so very well known as inside of you is something very special. Where is your strength?
Well, honestly, my strength comes from the belief in possibility. And if you asked me, Fernanda, 2 years ago or a year ago, if we would be seeing, based on our research, we have research to show that you can make your brain work better, you can make your heart work better, you can strengthen your immune system, you could lengthen your life, you could make the proper hormones to create more balance in your body. We have the research to show that in a matter of days, you can change your gene expression. So we have great evidence in human beings of what's possible. And you don't have to be a Buddhist monk or a nun or a rabbi or an academic. And by the same means, we have testimony from people that have healed themselves and changed their lives in so many dramatic ways. And that's evidence. So my strength really is in evidence. And my strength is in believing in human beings. And I see people of all ages, all economic levels, all different health conditions, all races, all cultures, all sizes and shapes do this. And I think that it's cool that we're seeing so many great things happen. So my strength is in the community of people really that do this work and live this work.
Dr. Joe, the last question. There are a lot of people in the world that are thinking that the brain is not here, that the brain is here, over here.
Yes.
Have you listened to that? I mean, it seems important because if the brain is here, then you can send the right connection to the brain in here.
Yes.
The other way. What do you think about that?
Well, I can talk extensively about that because we do extensive research on that very thing. So listen, I mean, other people will say you have a brain in your gut, and all you have is whenever you have a cluster of neurons together, the greatest number of clusters of neurons that are together is the expression of the greatest level of mind, the most intelligence, the ability to learn, to move, to adapt, to feel. Now, the brain is the central organ where we have the most number of connections. Mm-hmm. But in every hormonal center of your body, from your sexual center to your solar plexus to the center that digests food to your heart, there are little mini brains in each one of these centers that are constantly communicating with this brain up here. But what our research shows is that if you could open your heart and you have about 40 to 60,000 sensory neurites in your heart, clusters of neurons, when your heart becomes activated because you feel love, if you look at a brain scan that's connected to an electrocardiogram, what will happen when a person feels gratitude, their heart will start to beat in a very rhythmic fashion. That's called heart coherence. And what it does is it sends a wave of energy right up into the brain. And that you could see it right on a scan. And the person then moves into a more creative state. Now, they move out of survival, they move out of stress. That energy is, the heart is actually amplifying energy to the brain, and it's taking it out of the brainwave state of being vigilant and intense. It's actually causing the brain to come up with possibilities, to dream.
Wow.
And so the heart is the creative center, and when we activate our heart, it begins to influence how the brain can create and function. By the same means, once the heart becomes balanced and coherent and it goes to the brain, it begins to emanate a magnetic field around the body. Now the body's emitting energy and frequency carries information. And so we see then people who know how to create more coherence in their heart and more coherence in their brain actually are way more balanced than the person who's responding and reacting to everything in their life. And we have a technology, you know, a formula of teaching people how to do this. And when they practice it and they can measure, we can measure it, they start to feel the benefits of feeling more happy, more whole, more free, more creative, more, you know, more centered.
That's all we have to learn these days. Dr. Joe, can I tell you I love you?
Thank you so much, Fernanda. Thank you.
How did you feel today in this Fernanda Talk Home?
Oh, I'm always excited to share knowledge and excited to, I'm very, very connected to the Mexican community. I some of my best friends are Mexicans.
I know we have a friend in common, Salvador.
Yes, yes.
Thank you, Dr. Joe. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you so much, Fernanda.
Take care.
Ciao.
I love you. Ay, me encantó platicar desde su casa y mi casa hacia tu casa con el doctor Joe Dispenza. Bueno, pues hasta el próximo invitado. Por lo pronto, gracias por haberme acompañado.